With the B string, it actually works really similarly. However, I'm going to get you to not memorize the notes on the D string, but get them on the B string. And that's because things kind of change a little bit on the B string. For example, like if we were to play an octave, say if you grab fifth fret of the D string, to play an octave from there, you'd actually need pinky finger one fret higher. So because you can hear, like that's not an octave, right? That sounds like really quite dissonant. And so you get to bump that up one more fret. So all of a sudden our classic kind of octave shape is no longer consistent with the other strings. And that's fine. I mean, certainly this same method would work, but I've just found that the B string, because it is a different note, to be really helpful to memorize the notes on the B string. So let's just go through these really quick. So we've got B string on the third fret. Well, first we got B is open. So that's one of our notes that we need to find. So we got D on the third fret, E on the fifth fret, we've got G on the eighth fret, A on the 10th fret, and B on the 12th fret, and we've got D on the 15th fret, E on the 17th fret, and then we've got a G on the 20th fret of the B string. Okay, so once you get these notes memorized, then you'll just know your notes on the B string, which would then help you find the notes on the D string too. But like we said earlier, we can actually find our D strings really quite easily by knowing the notes on our low E string. So firstly, this is really important, and you'll notice if you check out the videos in my Classic Rock for Beginners courses, and it's later on in the series, by the way, it's some of the last videos. But we talk about finding these low notes on the E string and the A string to play bar chords. And also this is great for starting scales from, because you can actually start scales from these root notes. Okay, so maybe you're wondering, what about all the other notes? What about C sharp or B flat or A sharp or whatever the case? Now, by finding these five notes, it's going to be really easy to find where those other notes lie. For example, if we need to find out where a G sharp is, well, guess what? You already have a G and an A memorized, right? Because we really want to get these memorized on the E, the A, and the B string. So if you want to find a G sharp, that's going to be super easy, because if you know where a G is, then it just takes you like a half a second or less to find a G sharp, because it's just going to be one fret up from G. Okay, let's pick up another one, C sharp. Okay, that one's easy because you know where a D is. Okay, and to find a C sharp, then it's just one fret lower than that. And what you'll start finding is you'll start memorizing where these other notes are too, okay? So that takes care of all the other notes. And just by learning five notes, you can actually find out where all 12 notes are all over the fretboard by just using this memorization principle of learning these five notes and then the octave shapes to find out where they are on the remaining three strings. So again, what you want to do, your first step is to memorize your E, A, D, G, and B, those open strings, those particular notes on the E string, the A string, and the B string. And what you can do to test yourself is just to say, okay, where's a G note? G, 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 right? And I would really focus on the first 12 frets. So let's pick another one. Let's grab Bs. Okay, so B, B, B. Okay, and you should be able to go through them quick like that and just get them super, super memorized. Okay, so that would be your first step. And then from there, like I said, you can use those octave shapes to find them on the D string and the G string. And then also the E string gets repeated. So once you learn all your notes on the E string, then it's going to be easy to find G, A, B, and D on the high E string. So this has been really helpful for myself and my own guitar playing, because unlocking the fretboard is extremely important. It'll help you with soloing, understanding music, being able to communicate with other guitar players or other musicians, and will help you learn songs and just understand this whole guitar thing. Because, yeah, I mean, it just looks like an empty grid when you look at it, but hopefully this little tool that I'm giving you here will unlock it for you. So Enjoy this lesson. We'll catch you in the next one.